Hello and welcome. We are trying to keep in vogue with a very special guest. So, Shraddha Kapoor, what's your V style?
With me? Well, I guess I'll tell you how I am keeping my vogue with Vogue Eyewear is basically by showing my V side, which is singing. So, it's basically another facet to my personality, another passion that I have, which is singing. So that is my V-side, and that is something that I'm showing with Vogue Eyewear.
Shraddha, there's one thing I've been wanting to ask you. Why do film stars wear sunglasses indoors, even late evening? What is it that they're trying to hide? Now, come on, spill the beans.
You know, I think it's a good question. But it could be, I mean, personally, I'll speak about myself. If ever I have worn sunglasses in the evening, I feel like it's probably because, you know, I feel like my eyes are tired and, you know, and it's something that I want to cover up. So that's probably why for me. Yeah, there are days. No, there are good days and bad days. There are some days when you're like, you know, you would be more comfortable just covering up your tired eyes.
And by the way, the promos of Haseena Parkar looking very promising. What was it like working with your real-life sibling on reel?
Thank you. Oh, it was a fabulous experience working with my brother, sharing screen space with him, acting with him. It was actually very surreal. When do you get such an opportunity to share screen space with your real sibling? So it was exciting on so many levels. We would go back home together. We would discuss our scenes at home. So it was very special.
Also playing Haseena Parkar, often known as the godmother of Nagpara. So what was it like playing a character like her?
Right, sure. Well, for starters, I am playing a real-life character. A character who has existed and is not a fictional character. So our film is actually depicting the events that have happened in her life for what they have been. And we are showing all the different kind of perspectives, whether it's the perspective of the law, whether it's the perspective of her family. So there are different perspectives that have been touched upon in this film. And it was very challenging experiencing for me because I played from the age of 17 to about 45 in the film, and there was a transformation physically as well as mentally, and it was very challenging. Yes,
a lot of your contemporaries actually refused to do this particular role. So what made you say yes when you were approached to do this film?
You know, I really liked the story, and I was very intrigued by the fact that this woman had to go through so much loss in her life. And so I felt that that was interesting. It was an interesting story, and for celluloid, it would be a dramatic, a dramatic experience on celluloid as well.
Also, playing a real-life character comes with its own set of challenges, you know. There's always a reference point, and Haseena Parkar, as we all know, made the wrong headlines. So, but somewhere, you must have delved into her as a person that she was and then the person she became. So, what was it like?
Yes, absolutely. As I mentioned, the portrayal of Haseena and the other characters in the film are completely true to what actually had happened with her and the other characters in real life.
And you're playing another real life character, so how are the baddie lessons coming along for your Saina Nehwal biopic?
Well, it's coming along. It's coming along. I have a long way to go. I've done about 26 classes, and it's a lot of fun. Baddie is an amazing sport. It's really something.
So have you followed Saina's career, and was she the sports person that you always wanted to play?
Just the fact that she is our country, is one of our country's youth icons, and her journey has been tremendous, and at such a young age to, you know, get the title of world number one. And you get this feeling of immense pride when you know that that somebody from your country has managed to get that title. And when I was offered the film, I was so thrilled that I would get an opportunity again to do a biopic, and such an inspiring one.
You know, when we spoke to Sushant Singh Rajput when he played Dhoni, the challenge was to merge the real and the real together so people don't make out a difference. So you also are filling in very illustrious shoes, so it must be a challenge. Yes.
Absolutely, it is. It has its... I mean, you have no... you don't have the freedom of fiction when you're playing a real life character. You have to stay true to the real events that have unfolded in those respective characters. So yes, there are their own challenges. I really do hope that I am able to do justice to this character, because it is a mammoth of a challenge. Yes.
Also, another coup for you, after all those heroines that they were considering, it was you they chose for Prabhas's next Sahoo.
I am really, really excited. I'm really excited that I get to be a part of a, what, how would you say, not quadrilingual? I don't know how to say it will be Telugu, Hindi and Tamil, and if I'm not mistaken, it will be dubbed in another language as well, if I'm not mistaken. So it feels really awesome. I feel like we're at a time where regional cinema and cinema within India is going through such a change, and you know, I loved the script of Sahoo. It's absolutely exhilarating. So I'm really happy to be a part of it. And to be able to work with Prabhas, it's fabulous, yes.
Also, Shraddha, as an actor, you do face ups and downs, and each film comes with its own destiny. And sometimes you have a lot of expectations, but the film does not live up to it. So how do you deal with the blows, you know, with the negatives?
Of course, you know, when a film you've worked on, and you know, if people don't go and watch it, and then the film of course doesn't do well because people haven't gone to watch it, of course it's something that you know that you've worked on for months, and some films have even sometimes even years, and over a weekend the fate of the film is decided. So it is definitely heartbreaking. It is definitely heartbreaking when your films don't do well, and it feels amazing when your films do well. So, I try my best. The result and the outcome is never in anybody's control. And I just try my level best and try to better myself from my previous films. And because I know that when I watch the film, I don't want to feel that, you know, I didn't put in my 100%. I wouldn't want to feel that ever.
So if we want to keep up in vogue with Shraddha, the three must-haves.
Three must-haves that every girl must have to keep in vogue. So I'll answer this question keeping in mind the amazing sensibility of Vogue eyewear, which is show your Vogue, and show your V side, which is show your true self. And keeping that in mind, I would say that the three must-have things that you should have would definitely be your Vogue eyewear sunglasses, which you pick out for your personality. And I would say a bottle of water, very important. And also preserve water, everybody, please. And the third thing would be, I would say my phone, only so that I could, or your iPod or your phone, so that you can listen to music all the time.
Also interesting times for you as an actor, because there's new writing coming in, there are new directors coming in, new subjects being delved into, and also the box office has proved it doesn't need those mega budget, mega star driven projects. All that it needs is good content.
I completely feel so. I feel like the audience goes and watches films that they like, and films which have interesting and good content, And I really hope those films come my way and keep coming my way. And I think it is a privilege to be a part of a film which has really good content. So it is exciting. It is very exciting that content-driven films are doing well.
Also, Shraddha, lastly, what's on your wish list? Any particular director you want to work with? Any particular actor you want to work with? Or any kind of cinema that you want to do?
You know, I feel like I would have answered this question a lot differently, but I feel like I've had an evolution in the way that I think. I would really want good stories to come my way. And, you know, there's no hard and fast rule that it has to be this director, or it could be a newcomer who could have an immensely, incredibly talented idea.
Thank you so much. All the very best. Keep doing the kind of films that you do and keep entertaining us. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Nice talking to you. Thanks. Bye.